Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. We are going to build something like this using Provider. So you'd be able to add your favorite items or movies in a list like this. You'd be able to remove them and it becomes reactive. Of course, you can go to a new page, you can remove them again, come back and you see that the items are saved. And we'd be doing that using Provider. Let's get started. First, we'll go ahead and install Provider. Let's go ahead and get the latest version. Okay, so here in our list, we'll show our movies. These movies would be stored in a list, and in the list, we want to save them as an object. So that's why we'll go ahead and build a model. So here is my movie model dart file. So here we'll create a model. So here we'll have movie title and movie duration. So now we'll go ahead and create providers. So here we are generating 50 movies, and we are going to use the movie model, the one that we created earlier over here, and create an object based on that. And after creating object, we are going to save it in a variable like called initial data. And of course, it's a list variable which takes movie type. So here we created a class named movie provider, and this class, the state would be maintained by provider. So that's why we are using changeNotifier package, and we are going to use it, and we are going to use it with the keyword with. Here we created a list, and the list type is movie. And we are assigning the data, initial data, the one we created at the top. And we are going to save this in a variable called movies. Why we do that? Because we want to access this variable or this list from our UI. Since we are ready with this list, we'll go ahead and show this movie list in our UI. So here is our UI home screen. And over here, we created a stateful class. And inside the stateful class, we have this build method. And inside the build method, we are using the provider. We are getting the movie provider, the provider that we created early. Because of this provider, I can access this list over here and I can read the value from our home screen. So we read that using something called context.watch. So watch means basically, hey, whatever you are doing there, whatever the items in the movie list, I'm going to watch it. So if there are any changes, you should let me know immediately. Now, this movies list, we save it in this variable, which is called movies. Now we come down in our UI. Over here, we have a list view builder. First, we get the length, and then we read each of the movies from the list, and we just simply show the movie name, which is movie title, and the duration. Okay, right now we are in our main.dart file over here, and over here, because we are using provider, so we are injecting provider, and this is the entry point of provider. And with this, we are injecting the provider over here. So if you're coming from Getx or BLoC, so it is more like the get material where you have the entry point of Getx, but in provider, you use it more like changeNotifierProvider. For BLoC, you would use a BLoC provider. So they're pretty much similar. And once again, you are injecting the provider. In Getx, that is called controller, and in BLoC, that is called BLoC. And over here, we are calling our child, which is called home screen. And you do have to remember that you have to inject your child or you have to bind your child as well. So in our case, the child is my app, and my app would be able to access the provider and its sub children like home screen. So they all would be able to access the provider, since over here we are binding provider and my app together. So let's go ahead and run it. Right now, this is what we see. So we have the list of movies over here. And of course, the list once again is coming from our provider, which is inside this change notifier. This is not reactive, so we need to make it reactive. So the first thing we want to do, we want to go ahead and create a favorite icon over here, and we want to be able to click on that icon and add it in the list. Since we want to save our favorite movies in a list, so we have to go ahead and create a list. To create the list, we'll come to our movie provider over here, and right below it, we'll create a new list. So this list, which is called my list, it is empty right now. And as we click on this, as you click on a button like this, it would save the clicked movies or the items that we choose. But if we click again, it'll take the movies out of this list. Now we'll go to our home screen over here. And at the same time, and over here at the top, we want to access the list. Once again, this list would be responsible for saving data and removing data, because we want to click on this, save the data, come over here. And if we don't want, we want to remove the data, and all would be done using this list. We don't want to touch our original list. Original list would be responsible for showing the data on home screen. Now we'll come down over here at the bottom. Inside this list tile will create a new property, which is called trailing. So here is my trailing property, and inside trailing property, I have this icon button. And I have also an icon over here, as you can see. This icon would be reactive. We'll check if this icon has been pressed or not. So how do you do that? So we are going to use the my list, the list that we created at the top over here. As I said earlier, that over here we'll save the list that we press, unpress, or delete. So this will check using the method which is called contain, because the list has a method which is called contain, and we'll send the current movie to it. What is the current movie? The current movie is coming from here, the one we get based on index. And if the movie is there, we show it using the red color, using the favorite icon becomes red. Otherwise it stays white. And inside this onPress event, what we are going to do over here, we are going to call this method to add it in the list. So how do you call it? So once again, we have to use context.read. So for calling, we are going to use context.read. Of course, this method is still not there. This method is still not in our provider. We'll go ahead and create it. So we'll come to our movie provider over here, and right below it, we are going to create a method, which is called addToList. Now, as we call this method, we are going to add the movie object in our current list. And at the same time, we are going to update the UI using notifyListener. So this is more like the update method in Getx. Let's come over here and save it. And let's click on this, and it becomes red. Beautiful. As it becomes red, it's also get added to the list. So in general, you would not use context.read inside build method, but if it's inside onPressed method, that is okay. Now we want to remove it from the list. Now to be able to do that, we are going to go ahead and create a new method, which is called removeFromList. So we'll come over here, and right below it, we are going to create a new method. So as you see over here, we are calling the remove method from the list, because this method remove is built in. So we are passing a movie object, and we are going to remove it. Let's come to our UI over here, and let's restart. Let's click on this, so it becomes red. Let's remove it, it becomes white. You could do whatever the movie item you want. You can do at the same time as well. It doesn't really matter. So the state is persistent and saved. Now we want to create a movie list. So right now we are able to save them. So right now we are able to save them like this or remove them. But we also want to go to a new page and remove from here as well. So let's go ahead and do it. To be able to do that, we need to come at the top over here. And right before this expanded widget, we'll create an elevated button. Over here, we created this new section, which has elevated button icon. And inside this, we have an onPressed event. We want to be able to click and go to a new page. And at the same time, we are reading the movie length or my list length, that how many movies has been added in this list. Once again, remember that this list is dynamic, where we save our favorite movies on the on-click event. Well, let's go ahead and save it. And this is what we see. We see that we have four items in this list. Now you can go ahead and remove them, and it gets removed immediately. You can add one more, it gets added immediately. Isn't it beautiful? Now this is reactive once again because of this one, because we are using context.watch. So if you want reactive UI using provider, you have to get that provider using context.watch. And inside it, you have to call, actually, you have to call the provider, the one you want to listen for. Now we want to be able to click on this and go to a new page. For this one, we created a new Dart class, which is called FabMovies. And this is a stateful class. And inside this, once again, we are going to use this context.watch to know and get updated immediately all the time. So we are getting the list from our provider, which is my list, and we get the length as well. And then we are using list view builder to be able to read and display. Inside this, we are using index to get the movie object, and we simply just get title and duration. Now over here, inside this text button, we have onPressed event. We read it and delete it as we want. Now all we need to do, now once again, we are getting it using context.read, which is coming from provider, and we call the remove from list method, the one we created, the method we created, and at the same time we pass the movie, the current movie that's being selected. Let's go ahead and connect it inside our home screen. From here, we'll call the class, the one that we created. We can go to my list, and from here, we'd be able to remove, and we see that it changes immediately. You can come back and see the changes. You can add, go over here. Yeah, so that's how you learn the basic provider. If you have questions, leave a comment below, and thank you so much.